I just want to like take this in for a moment. We have more than one grade at Chapel. It's so exciting. I wish you could all see this. Hi. Okay, well, this is a super way to start our Wednesday, I think. Look back when you guys in the front. Isn't it nice just to see almost like a full group? Look at Mr. McManus back there, our fifth grade leaders. So cool. You know what? It occurred to me when I was thinking about this group coming in for chapel that this, so the third, fourth, fifth grade, this will be our middle school in a few years. Third graders will be sixth graders. Fourth graders will be seventh graders. And you awesome fifth graders will be our eighth grade leaders. Take that in for a minute. Isn't that cool? Like, this will be your athletic teams. This will be the group participating in the musical. You'll be running around outside like those middle schoolers changing for their classes. Lots to look forward to. So that excited me when I thought about that. Not that I want you to move on from lower school, but you guys are going to be great middle schoolers. So some things that we just need some reminders before we get our chapel started. Next week, next Monday, special day, Valentine's Day, one of my favorite days. So we have arranged a drop the dress code day. I need some enthusiasm. Thank you. So it is, yes, you can wear red, white, purple. Drop the dress code and have fun with what you wear, okay? It's going to be a fun day. If you all made your Valentines or maybe started to make your Valentines or brought in your little candies for your friends, it's just a fun day to show kindness to each other. So that's what I love about that day. We have something pretty neat going on outside my office. There is a collection that is growing daily. And as I run out of my, I often am running to a meeting or running somewhere because I'm running late. And I almost always trip over something that's outside my office, but it's a good thing. It always stops me. And I think, oh my gosh, this pile is really growing. So I think we're going to have some third graders coming up to tell us a bit about this collection. Sydney Scott, Ruhan Saini. So come up and tell us what is happening. And I can hold papers. I want you to be seen. So how can I help? You want to hold the mic?
Yes. Okay. The third grade has been collecting and will continue to collect until Friday cans of soup for the Lord's pantry in Downingtown. Please continue to our
Super Bowl of Caring and drop off your can of soup in the back of Bell Hall by Friday.
Third grade, thank you all.
Nice job. Okay. Thank you. So we also have Jack, Gianna, and Ava. Are you saying something about the Super Bowl as well for Mrs. Berger's class? Go ahead, Jack.
Who's ready for the Super Bowl of Caring?
We are. Wait, say it again.
Who's ready for the Super Bowl of Caring?
Woo! Nice.
Who's ready for the Super Bowl? Woo! Who's ready for some football?
So how simple is this, third grade? What do we have to do again? We have to
collect canned goods for the local pantry.
So we have a wonderful pantry here in our very own Downingtown, not far away. And what they do is they collect all this food for people who just don't have the funds to go to a grocery store like we all do week after week. Some of us go day after day. We're so fortunate to do that, but not everybody has those means. So I love that we're thinking of that. Soup cans are easy to find in your mom and dad's pantry, so definitely be looking for that. And when is the Super Bowl? When is this Super Bowl? The actual Super Bowl is? When is it, guys? Archer? It's on Sunday. Anybody looking for a win? Who are we looking to win? Henry, your hand shot. Who? Bang, you're a, who's a Cincinnati fan? Okay, yeah. I know. These aren't our Eagles. I know. We just have to make do. What about LA? Anybody an LA fan? Okay. So it's going to be a beautiful day, I think, out in LA where the Super Bowl is being held. So it'll be just fun to watch. We hope it's a great game and that we're doing something special to support that. So thank you to the third grade. Thank you, Mrs. Berger and Mrs. Frizz. Thanks, guys, for your enthusiasm. Good job. All right. Okay, our artist has arrived. Yay! So we are in the midst of our Visiting Artists Week, which I know you're all enjoying with Mrs. Hoover, Ms. Naur, Mr. Ormsby, and of course Mrs. O, and her artist is here today to talk a little bit to us in chapel. Wanted to just point out something that you all are working on with Mrs. Hoover's artist. Her name is Jessica Gorlin Liddell, and she's a mosaic artist, and this is what we're preparing. This is just the starting phase. So I went into the art room yesterday, and I was just blown away by the hard work you guys did in just one day with the artists. But isn't that beautiful? You Belong is the theme that we're going with, and that's going to be hanging on one of our walls. But I know what's really special about that is the kindergarten through the fourth grade are all contributing to that, so pretty special. So we're excited for that artist. And for Mrs. O is going to introduce her artist that has been spending the week with you guys in the music classes. So let's welcome Mrs. O to the stage.
Good morning. So we have really wonderful, talented, amazing students in our Montgomery Lower School. And I was wondering, because I definitely sense like a very high interest in music theater, acting, and singing. So I said, hey, let me search for a really great music theater person who could teach us really fun, engaging lessons to our students. So I was literally Googling and and searching for any person or teachers, and I came across this organization called Music Theater Philly, and I found this, I was introduced to this wonderful person, Miss Sarah. It's our third day with her, and she's been amazing, and we've had some great fun with her. So without further ado, let's introduce Miss Sarah.
How are we all doing today? Oh, wonderful. So my name is Sarah Ann Rabaton, but most of you know me as Miss Sarah. So it's wonderful to see you all today. I recognize some faces that I have seen before. Some new faces. Hi, yes, yes. I love it. And some new faces, and I see some grown-ups that I haven't seen before. So thank you guys for having me. It really, truly has been so much fun. And just can we give a big round of applause to the wonderful Mrs. O for just doing this for you guys. So really what I'm going to do today is just introduce myself, talk a little bit about me and kind of my career and what I like doing. And then I'm going to do a little presentation about some awesome Black theater artists for Black History Month. Yeah, so let's get started. So that's me. I know, it's a headshot, how pretty. So in theater, actors use headshots, and it's a way for us to get noticed. And for directors, I also direct, for us to get noticed and for people to know who we are. Like Mrs. O said, I come from a place called Music Theater Philly. We are a musical theater education company located in downtown Philadelphia. So that's why I was a couple minutes late today. I have a pretty long commute, but it's all worth it because you guys are pretty cool people. So let's see if I know how to do this. Maybe. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Theater is my strong suit, not technology, guys. Let's see what happens. Point it that way. Oh. Oh. Maybe. I know, guys. See, I told you. Theater is... Let's see. Maybe someone can help me do this. Oh, there we go. Round of applause for our tech back there. Yes. Yes. All right. So I'm just going to briefly talk about kind of how I got started in theater. So I was recently talking to a couple of friends, and they asked me, you know, Sarah, when did you feel like this was for you? And I was like, you know, I think I just came out of the womb an artistic person. I think I've just always loved performing, acting, singing, and dancing. And even though I didn't quite know when I was a tiny, tiny human being what all that meant, I knew that that theater was for me. I think my big moment was when I saw the 1998 VHS of Cats. Anybody? Maybe some grown-ups? Yeah. I mean, it hits different, doesn't it? It's awesome. But that was the moment where I was like, there are people like me that like to sing and dance and act and be theatrical. And that's something that's really important to me that I want to share with you guys, is that your creative talents matter. If you want to sing, sing. If you want to dance, dance. If you want to act, act. If you want to make a mosaic like I saw, if you want to sculpt, do it. Your creative talents matter. So, here are some pictures of me performing. So I perform, I direct, I write, I teach. I went to Rowan University for my undergraduate degree. That's in New Jersey. And I got a Bachelor of Arts degree in theater. And I focused in musical theater and theater education, which kind of was perfect for me because that's what I love, combining my love of teaching and performing and directing and writing. So, just to point out some fun pictures. Oh, there you go. Thanks. In my classes that you guys have been taking this week, I did mention directing, and that's something that's really important to me. So, that picture right there is the first show I ever directed, called Walking the Tightrope. And it's a TYA piece. TYA is an acronym. It stands for Theater for Young Audiences. So theater for folks just like you in this room. And that's something that I'm extremely passionate about. I want to make theater that anyone and everyone can see. And I'll point out maybe two more pictures. So that one right in the middle where I'm standing on a desk, that is from the Philadelphia Fringe Festival. So every summer into early fall, Philadelphia has a Fringe Festival. And so anyone, professional companies, everyday average folks, even people like you, can put up work. They can put up dance pieces. They can put up theater pieces. All you have to do is say, hey, I want to try this. And they'll be like, cool, okay. So pretty cool stuff. That was an original piece called It's Happening at Home. I think the final one I'll talk about is right at the tippy top. And it's a bunch of people standing in a semicircle. And the shortest one is me, because I'm only 5'1". I just stopped growing when I was 14, you know. But that was a really important piece to me. That was my senior year of college. And it was all women, and we created a tap dance piece together. And it was really wonderful. So that's a little bit about me. I really love being a theater teacher so much. I'm getting my master's degree from NYU in educational theater in colleges and communities. Very long title, but basically it means I get to keep doing what I love doing and learn more about how I can be better at what I do. So, does anybody have any questions about that before I get into my like actual presentation? Cool. If you think of some, feel free to raise your hand, because yeah, let's do it. All right. Let's move on. Woohoo! So Black History Month. Important, right? Important to celebrate all of the Black excellence, the Black joy that we see. And I really wanted to celebrate Black theater artists. So let's meet some. So I'm going to give you a super, super, super brief history of Black theater in America. You could take like college courses about each of these eras, right? So this is super brief. So we're going to talk about Black theater starting in the late 1800s and early 1900s in vaudeville. And so vaudeville is a type of theater. It's not as popular today, but there was a lot of singing and dancing and lots of variety shows happening. In the late 1800s and early 1900s, unfortunately, a lot of the Black artists that were on stage were kind of portrayed in stereotypes in ways that really aren't great. But I think it's important mentioning, because I think you can see from where we started to where we are, how we're now really celebrating Black artists. Then we have, oh, could we just go back? So then we have one of my favorite eras, the Harlem Renaissance. So Harlem is a neighborhood in Manhattan in New York City, and it has traditionally had a lot of Black folks living there. And in the 1920s and 30s, there was this thing called the Harlem Renaissance. So lots of Black artists, and not just theater artists, dancers, singers and actors, yes, but also sculptors, writers, poets, people like Langston Hughes, Lorraine Hansberry, they really came together and created, and it was this hugely important part of what it means for the arts in America. And it started in Harlem, but it spread. So the Harlem Renaissance affected not only all of New York City, but even places like PA and Philadelphia, which is near us. Then we have this post-World War II era, and this was hugely influential because we started thinking about social justice and really talking about issues that Black folks faced. So things like racism and segregation. That's when theater artists really started creating art about that. And in this era, in the late 60s, produced one of, I think, the most important pieces in theater, the musical Hair, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. Then we have some of our cultural landmark musicals that you guys might know about from the 80s and 90s. Maybe Dreamgirls, it's a dope one. And The Color Purple, which was a book originally, then became a movie, and then it became a musical. And The Color Purple is one of my favorite shows of all time. And then, just to set it off now, contemporary world, we're really creating all this awesome work by Black artists, Black singers, Black technicians, and really centering Black joy, which I think is awesome. So let's meet some of these cool theater artist people. We can go to our next slide. Woohoo! We got our guy, Charles Gilpin. He's got to be one of the greats. So, he was one of the first ever Black actors on Broadway because, unfortunately, in the beginning, Broadway was segregated. And he played the lead in Emperor Jones, and he was the first Black lead in an integrated cast. So there were white folks, Black folks, Asian folks, Latinx folks in this cast, and that was unheard of in the 1920s. And it was a play by Eugene O'Neill, and he's considered one of the really most important playwrights in American theater. And he was the first Black actor to receive a Drama League Award. Drama League Award is similar to a Tony. Does anybody know what the Tony Awards are? Raise your hand if you do. Yeah. So the Tony Awards are the awards for Broadway actors. And so the Drama League Award is similar to that. So that was really important. All right. Let's go to our next slide and meet our next person. Again, a great lady. We got our girl, Juanita Hall. So, Juanita Hall originated the role of Bloody Mary in the musical South Pacific. And South Pacific is a Rodgers and Hammerstein musical that really changed theater. It was, again, one of those first musicals where we got to see white folks on stage, Black folks on stage, Asian folks on stage, all different types of people together in a musical. And that came out in 1949. And she performed that for nearly 2,000 performances, which, oh my goodness. I know some of you had asked me how many shows have I been in, and it's probably close to 100, but I can't even imagine doing one show 2,000 times. That's some talent right there. And she was also in the movie that came out in 1957. There's also one from 2001, but the one from 1957 is better. Oh, it's all good. We can move on to our next slide. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the incomparable Melba Moore, one of my all-time favorites. She was in Hair in 1969, which is a show I mentioned before. But she was also in Pearlie, and we're going to watch a clip from that. And she won the Tony Award for that, and that really changed her career. So she mostly transitioned to music. And she actually still performs on Broadway. She's in her 70s, and Melba is just like, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to keep working, which is pretty awesome. All right. We can move on to our next slide. And then we have, one of my favorites, Miss Debbie Allen. So Debbie Allen really kind of does it all, and she still does it all in her, I think she's 80 now. So she performed on Broadway in Pearlie, the show I mentioned before, Ain't Misbehavin', and West Side Story. She got a Tony nom for that. And there's videos of that on YouTube. Oh, check it out, because the way she kicks her legs, she said, yes, I will be nominated for that Tony. And she really became famous on the TV show Fame. So has anyone heard of that show before? All the grown-ups are like, yeah, woohoo. Yeah. So Fame was a super kind of influential show from the 1980s, and then it became a musical, actually. And it has been, I think there was like a reboot on TV, but it's based on the Performing Arts High School in New York, and it's very dramatic and over the top, but it really did change the landscape of what people thought was possible on TV and kind of how making theater and TV come together. Things that we think are pretty obvious now. And yeah, she's directed for a ton of stuff. I mean, most recently she directed Dolly Parton came out with a Christmas movie and she directed it. And I was like, all right, Debbie Allen, go off. I love it. All right, I think we have two more slides. Let's see. One of our favorites, LaShawn's. So I don't know if we have folks in this room who are doing the number that I taught you guys from Once on This Island. But LaShawn's originated the role of Timon, and she won the Tony Award for that in Once on This Island. I was actually listening to Once on This Island yesterday on the way home from Montgomery School, and I started crying because it's so beautiful. You know, just Miss Sarah things. And she actually attended U Arts in Philly. So University of the Arts is this arts college in Philadelphia that actually a couple of my friends have attended. So if you're thinking about being a performer or a writer or a director or something, U Arts might be the place for you. And so, like I said, she originated the role of Timon, but she also was Celie in The Color Purple. And she won the Tony Award for that. And I remember when she won the Tony Award for that because I was 10 and I was watching the Tony Awards and I was like, yes. It was amazing. All right, I think we have some video clips. Let's see. I think that's my next slide. Oh, we have one more. So has anybody seen the new West Side Story movie? Yes, yes. It's really, really excellent. West Side Story is a super important musical in the musical theater canon. And canon is just a fancy word for all the stuff that exists in musical theater. So Erin Ojibwe, actually, as of yesterday afternoon, is an Academy Award nominee for her role as Anita, which I think is really, really awesome. So she's an Afro-Latinx actor, director, writer, dancer. She was in Motown the Musical. That's where she made her Broadway debut. She was in Pippin, which is also, we live for Pippin. And she originated the role of the Bullet in Hamilton. Has anyone seen Hamilton? Yeah, I figured half the room would be like, yes, we have. And so some of you who are in my class, we did a dance to the Schuyler Sisters, right? Fun stuff. Yes, exactly. So she originated the role of the Bullet in that musical. And so I think she's in the film version on Disney Plus. So if you watch it, you'll get to see her. And like I said, she just got nominated for an Academy Award. So I'm hoping she wins because she definitely deserves it. If you haven't seen the new West Side Story, highly suggest. All right, I think next we have some video clips. Cool. All right, so this first clip is just a short clip from West Side Story. So I think if you click it, it should begin. Let's see what happens. Then it's the scene where they kiss. Oh, the drama. Blech. I know. Gross, right? But yes, yeah, so Ariana just got nominated, and that role of Anita is really, really influential in musical theater. So this next one is a little clip from Melba Moore, which is one of the people we talked about, and this is her 1970 Tony Awards. Have any microphones on stage. So she's just singing out. Good. All right, we can move on to our next slide. It's all good. Let's see. I think I have one more clip. Yes. Okay, so this is a quick clip, and we might have to, we'll watch like maybe a minute and a half of this. But this is from Once on This Island. Is anybody in this room doing my Once on This Island? I think that might just be the second graders, right? This is third, fourth, fifth, right? Yeah, yeah. Okay. So this features one of our performers that we just talked about named LaChance. It also features one of my all-time favorite performers, Miss Lilias White. Mm. Wow, what a lady. So this is Once on This Island. And we can, if you could skip maybe to like 1 minute 30 seconds, and then we'll watch a minute or two from there. Awesome.
Here now, Tony.
The girl lost all her fear. She knew Mama Earth was near.
You never been away from the sea, child. You're gonna need a helping hand. A fish has got to learn to swim on land. Walk with me, little girl, don't you be afraid.
Thank you guys so much. That was my presentation. Does anybody have any questions or comments or anything like that? Oh, I saw a hand right there. So the question was, the play that I directed, Walking the Tightrope, great question, by the way. I have had some awesome interactions with Montgomery School kids the past 3 days. It's been awesome. But the script of Walking the Tightrope is public online. My production that I directed is not, because it was a school production, so I couldn't, get it out. Oh, I had one my hand right here.
Hold on 1 second.
Yes.
We're going to have you repeat that.
What's your favorite thing that you've directed?
Such a good question. Oh, my favorite thing that I've directed. Well, I wrote a show called Under the Moon, and I think that's my favorite thing I've directed because it actually came from me, and I was like, wow, something that was in my head is now in front of me on stage. All right. Oh my gosh, I see three more hands. Let's see, can we get to over there?
What is have you been a lead of a show?
Yes, I have been a lead in a show. Yes, it's been super fun. I think my favorite was, this might have not have been a favorite of all time, but it really did change my confidence level in theater when I was in high school. I was Golda and Fiddler on the Roof, but it really did kind of change. Oh, wow, I can really do this. Yeah, okay, I think there's a hand over there.
How long have you been doing this?
20 years. A really, really long time. I've been in a lot of shows. I think we probably have time for maybe, what do we think, two or three more? Is that right, teachers? Yeah. Cool, okay.
When did you start acting?
When did I start acting? Well, officially, I started when I was in fourth grade. I was Long John Silver in Treasure Island, and I was like, oh, right. But I think I've been acting since I was a tiny, tiny human. I just love playing pretend. Cool. Let's do three more. Is that good? Yeah.
How many times have you directed?
Great question. So officially right now, 4 times. But hopefully by the end of this year, it'll be 5, guys. That's what I'm hoping. Let's do 2 more. Go ahead.
What was your favorite play that you were an actor in?
Great question. It's a hard question because I've had so many. I've been really lucky that I've had a lot of great experiences in theater, but I think my most recent favorite is I was Sally in You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, and that's such a fun role to play. Yes. I think we can do one more.
One more, maybe?
Yeah.
What's the least favorite play you've directed in?
I love that question. What's my least favorite? Here's what I'll say. I like to think that even shows that I didn't love being a part of, they still taught me something. So my senior year of college, I was a part of this show called The Cradle Will Rock, and it's this Brechtian show, which, for those of you who know who Brecht is, it's whew, right? Really intense, and it was hard. And even though I didn't love every second of it, I think, again, it taught me, I really can, even shows that are really hard and things that I'm like, whoa, I don't know if I can do this, I totally can. If I work really hard at it, I totally can. Cool. Cool. Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much. If you have any other questions for me or anything else you want to share, I'm seeing most of you today or over the next few days. And I know fifth graders, I'm not seeing you guys, but if you see me around, you're more than welcome to say, hey, Miss Sarah, what's up? But thank you guys so much. I really appreciate it. Thank you.